Who's ready for trash day?
Trash day!
Bye!
Should we show everyone what you do when I try and do laundry? I moved the basket, and then guess what? He decided that he knows how to jump up. Or Calvin picks him up. So every time I do laundry, he ends up jumping up here. He learned how to jump up, and he takes off with someone's underwear, someone's sock, and he runs off.
That's his trick.
That's his trick. Over the last few weeks during quarantine, we have watched so many movies, but there is something else that I have been implementing a lot, and they've been helping out so much. You guys, if you've watched my channel long enough, you know that Jackson always takes out the trash in the house, but they also can put their own laundry away now. It's been really helpful. So I've been folding laundry, I have everything laid out, and I have the boys' piles in their own piles, and I always have them take two trips. And like, for instance, I'll say Calvin, because he's almost five and he gets distracted easy, and I'll tell him, go hang these up and come back to mom. So he hangs them up and he comes back, and then I say, okay, go put your underwear and pajamas away. And then he'll go do that, and then I will go check it, and it doesn't have to be perfect as long as he tried. Like, if he just like threw it on the ground in his room, then I'll sit there while he puts it away. But they're doing really good at putting their own laundry away. So that's what we're gonna do right now, is I'm doing a bunch of laundry. I'm gonna put Tommy's and my stuff away. Excuse me while I yawn. And the boys will put their stuff away. I also think it's time to buy new socks for Tommy. I think these are the only socks he has, and they're like half mixed matched. And yeah, I think Tommy needs some new socks.
And I have to poop so bad, and I'm like trying to figure
what?
Out.
What?
He pooped in my
Where
office.
Where is he?
He went over that way. Okay, will you take care of the poop and the dog?
Ah, that was such a cute moment, and it went crappy real quick.
Literally.
Rollerblades.
Yeah, I know you're wearing rollerblades. He just rolled right on past me, and I went, oh, you're huge. You're almost seven. Six and a half. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. Okay, go outside with those now.
Okay.
Hi, Copper. Hi. Something that I have noticed during quarantine is the boys have been so creative. They have been playing. They've been bored. They've not been entertained. We haven't gone anywhere. They haven't played with friends. They have been thriving. Yes, we've had some really rough days. Yes, I have had some meltdowns, some panic attacks, anxiety. It hasn't always been pretty, but for the most part, my kids have thrived. So it got me thinking. I would say I'm not a minimalist, but I like things minimal. I like to keep my home clean. I like to keep it organized. It doesn't mean it's always clean, but for the most part, like my cupboards, everything is pretty tidy. I don't keep a lot of extras in my house. But this quarantine has got me thinking, my kids don't really play with their toys. They never really have. They play outside, they play with their bikes, they love movies, and they have a few toys that they play with. In my home, something I'll never get rid of is three things: Hot Wheel cars. You can play with those from 0 to 100 years old. Books, I will never get rid of books. Those are amazing to have in your home. Kids love to flip through them, it's great for them. And the third thing I would never get rid of is the figurines. The plastic farm animals, the dinosaurs, the little figurines. I won't get rid of those. The last few months I have been getting rid of and donating and selling a lot of things that just don't bring us joy. The kids entertainment center downstairs that was chock full of toys, I was sick of looking at, I was sick of picking it up, and the kids never played with the stuff anyway. So I sold the entertainment center, I moved all the toys into each of the boys' rooms. Now we're going, a few months later, we're gonna go through those rooms again, and we are going to choose two to three toys for them to keep. That's right, everything else is going except the three items that I previously talked about. Who's ready for trash day? Come along. Who is ready for room one? This is what we ended up getting rid of. We have a deflated ball, some toys that we're gonna donate. It's hard to get rid of items because I have more of an emotional attachment to them. But really, does it matter? Like, it's just stuff in the house that doesn't get played with at all. So all of these that really just don't get played with, I am tossing. There is a few Disney toys in there that, again, I'm kind of sad about, but we have some Disney photos downstairs and a few like Disney, like Minnie and Mickey Mouse on a shelf that we will obviously keep, but we don't need all of the toys. So those are going in the bag. This is what we're keeping. All of the books, stuffed animals. Those are the figurines I was talking about that we would always keep. So he has his little car that he drives inside. He has a little play toy that he plays with in here. And his blocks with an RC car. So to me, this is pretty minimal. And Calvin, should we go to your room next? I gave the boys a bag and I said, you start and I'll come down and finish. These are the items that Calvin has decided to put in a donate bag. Pretty good, that's a great start. We're gonna go through and really determine what toys are getting played with and what is not, and we will fill up this bag to donate. Excuse me, where did the camera just go?
I donated it!
After I pulled you guys out of the donate pile, I wanna show you guys how we are doing this. I'm laying several toys out. I don't really know what ones out of these Calvin plays with the most between that toy and like these bigger ones. So I'm gonna have Calvin go through and choose his top three of all of these. So Calvin, you wanna keep that one?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's put it right here on a keep pile.
I got a lot of stuff.
You did get rid of a lot of stuff. Good job.
But not this.
Oh yeah, that's a cool tattoo. We are going to be donating this, and Calvin by far wins so far the most bags donated. We are donating three bags of items that we just don't utilize and need. So in the closet, we have our train set. Those are tons of like a puzzle train set that we have. So that's in there, and then he got to keep one costume with his boxing gloves. And then this is a set that he got for Christmas that he plays with all the time. So I'm counting this set as one. So he has his set, he has his puppets and doll, and these toys are what he plays with. So this is what is staying in Calvin's room. The books, the blocks, and the Hot Wheel cars to me really don't count because those are like what we will always keep. So good job, Calvin, for minimizing your items. You just scared me.
I'm so sorry.
Hi.
Is it because I cleaned up?
It looks great. I thought you were gonna completely shave it. It actually looks really great.
I found a 3mm trimmer in the bathroom and I was like, I'm gonna use that.
It actually looks great.
Thanks. I spent like 20 minutes like doing the every single line and I was just like, it still looks like garbage because it's just so like gangly.
It's not.
And gross. And so I found that and I was just like, and so I feel like this,
it looks
like,
great.
It's still a little patchy, but I like it a lot better. I will.
It looks great.
Thanks.
Kay Jackson, you're next. So once again, it's harder on mom because it's like an emotional attachment. There's still quite a bit of toys in here, but I would definitely say this is more minimal. And that's one of the things with kids is they don't need tons of overstimulating things. They don't need 10 costumes. Is it fun to give your kids 10 costumes? Yeah. Over the last few years, my kids have accumulated a lot of costumes. Do they ever wear all of the 10? No, they have their favorites. So Calvin picked his dinosaur, and we'll go see what Jackson picked.
I hurt my toe on the door.
Dang it. What else did we do? Got rid of some stuff. Are you guys ready to see? Jackson got rid of a whopping 3 bags as well. Oh my goodness. Let me show you what we ended up keeping with Jackson's room. So all of our art supply stuff, I guess I should have said there's 4 things we would keep. Obviously, we're not gonna like throw away all of our crayons and stuff. So that is his area in his room. We ended up getting rid of his chair.
It broke.
We've had a lot of cousins. We've had a lot of kids on it. It's been tipped a lot. It's had its time. So starting over here, Jackson has a game. He has books. Remember, books don't really count. He has his, what are those?
Boxing gloves
and magic. Those are figurines in there, little toy animals, and then his monster truck. And then he has his basketball on his door, and then he has his doll stuff with...
Hey, where's the stuff?
With magnets. It's in here. Those are the other things that go with the doll stuff. And then his costume, which is Spider-Man, along with his books. And then he has his marble run in his closet, but we put that away because of small marbles.
Here, let me show you guys.
And with Tommy. Yep, there's your marble run. Good job! Do you feel good getting rid of stuff, or are you sad? How are you feeling?
I'm good.
You're good? Okay. Well, we will donate and get rid of some of this stuff. This is where the kids play with their Play-Doh, where they color. We have paint that they do. This is where we hang up their art supplies. And there used to be 2 huge cabinets here that were full of toys. And it just...
Hey guys.
I didn't love it. So they ended up putting it in their rooms, and then we just went through their rooms and cleaned up. So our house is feeling pretty good.
I made these.
You did. It looks so great. Yeah, that was awesome, Jackson. So what we're going to do is we have plenty of outdoor toys that Tommy plays on, that he rides. Again, this is an emotional attachment. We don't need this. We're going to donate it. It served its purpose. We've had it for 3 kids, and they all used it and played with it. But we don't really need it. It's hard to like get rid of, but we are. We're gonna donate this because we have several bikes outside for all of the kids to play on, and then Tommy has his little red thing up in his room. So we'll donate that. And then obviously these are just some fun pictures that we'll keep. So this is pretty good. High five. You know what my kids love to play with the most?
Superhero!
Couch pillows.
All right, Marie Kondo, I think it's time.
It's not bringing me joy.
I think it's time to take a little bit of break before we start donating the kids themselves.
No way!
Let's have dinner and then we can finish everything up, okay?
Perfect. Thank you guys for watching this vlog. For the last 5 weeks, we have been quarantined to our house. I have seen firsthand how much my kids have grown in their imagination.
Playing together is like one of the things that they've excelled the most in with the quarantine. They're not always just watching TV and playing video games. They're going on adventures in the basement together. And it's like, it literally brings tears to our eyes. It's so sweet.
They've been so much more creative. And I know that clearing out our space with junk and excess stuff, even for me, I've been cleaning out my closet as well, it's just a good feeling to have. So they still have plenty of stuff to play with. It's just we're honing in on what's a little more important,
right? And those things are the things that are going to last us a lot longer. Those are the things that they're going to want to have when they're our age. And looking back, we each have buckets of things that we love. Like, I mean, you have some toys that you've taken care of like better
forever
than anyone.
Yeah.
I know. So these are the toys that they're keeping that they'll have when they're older. So like, that's the cool part about it, is like these are memorable toys and
the
trinkets that they have.
Okay. Thank you guys so much for watching.
We'll catch you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.